Hey there, Amy394. So one of the questions that I've heard a couple times, and I know is really important for all of us, is understanding where we are going. What am I on about? Why are we doing all of these different pieces where we're building interfaces along the way, and how does that connect with building an actual program that I can use outside of the networking environment that we've done all of our work in? So part of what we're on about is we're kind of dreaming up a way, we're kind of working our way towards having an interface that we're going to build. And why that's important is that if we're running in perform mode, let me pull this in over here. When we're running here in perform mode, we don't have access to the network editor. And in fact, that's what I want. I don't want to have access to the network editor because it takes a bunch of additional resources to draw all of the elements that are associated with it, drawing all the preview windows. There are all sorts of things inside of the networking and patching environment that are going to slow me way down when it comes to live performance. So when I set up an installation, or if I'm working with a band, or if I'm doing a VJ set, or you name it, whatever it is that I'm doing with the program that I've written, as much as possible, I want to avoid actually working in the patching environment, in the network environment. But that doesn't mean that I don't want to be able to change my program in some way, right? So part of what's important is that we're able to use a button to invoke a command that then allows us to open up a control panel that we can then use to drive and manipulate different pieces of our network without actually having to go inside of it and drive it inside, manipulate it in the patching environment. Right? Because there are lots of different elements that I've set up here that I can go ahead and control from here with this control element without having to be inside of my network. So to give you a sense of where we're going, this is a part of what we're after, is the ability is to give you the ability to open up a window where you can make those changes, dismiss it, and then still be able to let your program run here in performance mode. And if you didn't like it, you could do the same thing. You could invoke that window again, change some more of these parameters, kind of figure out the place that it's supposed to be, dial it in so it's just right. Okay, yeah, maybe a little less of this and maybe none of that. Whoa. And then dismiss that again. So that's a part of what we're after, because what you are going to create at the end of the day might be something like this, it might not be something like this. But as a standalone application, I've now built something, oh my God, it's moving too much, that doesn't require that I'm working in the network environment at all. And in fact, this is something that I could turn over to a client, and the client could even manipulate or drive. So that's a part of what we're up to. That's a part of where we're going here in this week and next week. But before we can get there, we first have to learn how do we make all of these different buttons? How do we build these control elements? And then once we build, we have a sense of how to build those widgets, those pieces, then we can think about how do we connect them to the thing that we've already built so that we have an application that will stand on its own. And then after that, we'll start to look at how you build something that is totally new and different. Because then we'll have gone through the process from beginning to end of creating our very own application that runs by itself. And then it's time for me to turn you loose and let you really make something that connects with what you're interested in. So we're getting there, I promise. Don't worry. And thank you so much for being patient. Because the next couple weeks are going to be really exciting and really fun.